we have Sri Sujit Kanoria. Sri Sujit Kanoria, we are awaiting his remarks.
Ladies and gentlemen, esteemed speakers, leaders, my father and family, I think it has been a very interesting day today with the various learnings the different speakers have shared. I wanted to talk very briefly about one of those faculties which we all have and we must pursue and connect to. As to me, this evolutionary trait is what drives me, excites me, and makes me live. I call this imagination. In the spiritual life, imagination has two meanings. First, it is a human faculty, the part of us that traffics in images, symbols, myths, and stories. It is a capacity we all have for innovative thinking and creative expression. Second, the imagination is an inner reality, a boundless realm, not defined by our senses or reason that we know from our dreams and can enter via certain exercises while awake. The practice of imagination encourages us to use this faculty and enables us to explore the realm. Many of us live the greater part of our lives on the surface of mystery. We are restless, aware that we exist on the threshold of something more. How? We wonder, can we connect with this mystery? The imagination enables us to cross over. It does this by opening us to the ultimate in finite reality, to the depth at the heart of the matter. For it is the imagination that holds together matter and spirit, enabling us to know the concrete in terms of its pervasive mystery. The true power of imagination is that it can be used to drive us towards spirituality and the ultimate. Imagination is what I feel makes us connect to another, empathize with him or her. How many of us in this forum have been hungry for, say, 2 or 3 days? I don't know, very few, I guess. We may not have been in that situation, but the tenet of imagination makes us be in that situation and hence be able to empathize with another person who has actually been in that circumstance. I feel it is through this gift that we can have empathy, as this power of imagination makes us understand the others' perspectives. I would not like all of you to think that I'm veering away from the subject of this confluence and talking about more creative concepts such as imagination. But I truly believe that finding God in all things is ultimately a function of the imagination. I'm able to behold God in all because I can imagine the divine presence everywhere. But I cannot see God the way I see my computer or my keyboard physically present in front of me. I have to imagine God. And that's what enables me to believe, to behold, to find the Supreme. This imagination is what I believe creates a faith, a hope, and that yearning for the higher connect. One question was asked by the audience in the last session of Mr. Peer, which was how to infuse spirituality in our daily lives. Try imagination, and I repeat to all in this audience, try consciously tomorrow to just do something with your imagination faculty totally fired up. Try it and enjoy that. Enjoy that connect to spirituality through imagination. God bless and thank you.